Dr. Mir Taimur Hamid, Pakistan. In my country, mosques are open and the government is instructing to take precautions to maintain social distancing. My question is, since coronavirus is still spreading outside and chances of spreading are still there, if one goes to the mosque for prayer, can I offer my prayers and Jummah at home until the spread of the disease is minimized? Can I miss my Jummah and daily prayers in the mosque in this situation? It's a very important question. And let me tell you that never in the history of Islam has it ever happened in the past that majority of the mosques throughout the world have been closed like now. Maybe 75%, more than 75% of the world, the mosques are closed because of this coronavirus, COVID-19 pandemic. But if, and I know there are certain countries which haven't closed the mosque, and many parts of Pakistan, I'm aware that the mosques haven't been closed and the government has permitted. What should you do in such a case? First, let me tell you that it is the duty of, if it's an Islamic country, it is the duty of that country that if they have come to know that there is a pandemic, there is an epidemic, and there are chances that people can get infected, it can be dangerous. So the best that Islamic country should do is they should ask the person who's knowledgeable in that field. As Quran says, Fas'alu ahli zikri in kuntum la ta'lamun. In Surah Nahl, chapter 16 verse 43, they should take the advice of the health authorities. At the same time, consult the fuqahas, the muftis of the country. And they should have a joint meeting. And that's what was very well done in Malaysia. In Malaysia, they had a very good meeting where they call all the health specialists, they call the muftis of all the states and the Islamic scholars, and they discussed. And based on the pros and cons, they decided that shutting down the mosque and preventing the public to pray in the mosque in general, it will cause more damage, and they closed the mosque, irrespective whether the individual agrees or not. Whether I agree or not in the Islamic thing, if the Muslim country, taking into consideration the fuqahas and the medical authorities, if they say that no one should pray in the mosque, then we should follow the rules, except most of the countries have said that two or three people make the jamaat so that the jamaat continues in the mosque. But if an Islamic country and the government and the ruler, in consultation with the fuqahas and the medical authorities, if they give this, whether a Muslim agrees or not, you should follow it. What I don't agree, that those countries in which coronavirus hasn't come yet, no one has died, or maybe two or three people are infected, they are closing without any consultation. This is not correct. I don't agree that everywhere in the world, all the mosques should be closed. If the coronavirus hasn't entered your country, or only very few people are infected, and you know that no one has died, and if you feel to take, you can take a lot of precaution before shutting down the mosque completely. And in this case, just because the other Muslim countries are doing it, we should do it. If a non-Muslim country gives an order, mosque should be closed, we as Muslims should obey the law of the country. Especially it is in consultation with the medical authorities. So even in a non-Muslim country, if the country gives an order that the mosque should be closed, and we know that the Muslim country is also closing mosque, then you as a Muslim living in a non-Muslim country should obey the law of the country. But there are certain countries in which coronavirus hasn't entered. No cases. Or maybe few are infected. No one has died. And then they're doing it. I have my reservation. You can always have a meeting. And there can be various steps before you close down the mosque. For example, you can take precaution. And same, my answer goes to this brother, that if the country has not closed down the mosque, and I said you take precaution yourself, then according to me, praying in the mosque becomes the fard. According to all the scholars, praying in the mosque the five times salah is fard. According to some scholars like Imam Adhabi, they say that if you don't pray in congregation five times salah in the mosque without a valid reason, it is a major sin, gunaya kabira, sin number 65. And there are other scholars also who have said that it's a major sin if you do not pray in the mosque regularly without a valid reason. What I would suggest in such cases, before closing down the mosque, there are various other options, especially if there is very few cases and no one has died or very few people have died. Number one should be that every Muslim should get his own sajjada. Because if you are praying in the sajjada, the carpet of the mosque, someone else has prayed before, the person while doing sujood, he breathes in, breathes out, high chances that if anyone is infected, you can get infected. Number one is, if a Muslim is infected, it is haram for him to go to the mosque. When you have onion, when you have garlic, you should not go to the mosque. So where is the question of going to the mosque when you have an infectious disease? So if you have an infectious disease, it is haram for you to go to the mosque. If you are infected with the COVID-19, stay at home, pray at home, inshallah you'll get an equal sawab, you have a valid reason. If you have not got infected and the mosques are open, like in Pakistan and some other country, like in Yemen and other countries, then advisable is that you should go. You can take your precaution, and before closing the mosque, these countries should take precaution. Number one is get your own sajjada, your own prayer mat, so that someone who has come before should not infect you. Number two, please don't shake hands with your other Muslim brothers, the women amongst women and men amongst men. Do not. Number three, don't scratch your nose or rub your eyes or touch your face. Why? Because if your hand touches a place which has got this virus, you should not infect yourself. So see to it, you don't scratch your face, don't touch your face, very important. Number four, there can be hand sanitizers kept, so that if you fear something has happened, you can always sanitize your hand. So these precautions, there are gadgets available which even sanitize the whole body. You have to go through it, stay for a few seconds, there are some fumes coming, it sanitizes you. This can be done. There are various precautions. You can wear a mask and go to the mosque. And if you fear it's very high, since it's not obligatory and a fard for the woman to pray in the mosque, and most of the Gulf countries and many other countries, women go to the mosque and they constitute maybe 20% of the musalli, some 15%, some 25%. You can always tell them not to come, because for the woman to pray in the mosque is not fard. So you can tell women should not come to the mosque, no problem. Furthermore, if you feel that there is a little more danger, you can say, like some countries have done that, Turkey has done that, that all those above the age of 65, they should not come out. You can also say that don't come to the mosque, because people above the age of 65 have got high chances of getting infected. And when they get infected, the immunity is low, high chances of the mortality. You can always ask the musalli to reduce the time in the mosque by less than half by doing wudu at home. You can ask the musalli, the Muslims, to pray the sunnah salah at home. Praying sunnah is not required to pray in the mosque. The sunnah before the fard salah, the sunnah after the fard salah, and many a time the sunnah occupies more time than the fard salah. So pray the sunnah at home. So if you, and you can take many other precautions. So if you fear that the pandemic is not very high and the curve is not very high, the mosque can be kept open. And take the precaution, take as much precaution as possible. There are more precautions that you can take. If you feel that's going to be detrimental to the people, and if the authorities have a consultation with the fuqahas, with the scholars and with the medical authorities, and close the mosque, then Muslims should not go and pray in the mosque. But as for this question, this brother asked, I want to be safe. You want to be safe? Then do the things I told you. Take your sajjada, wash your hands, don't shake hands, don't scratch your face, don't touch your face, do wudu at home, pray sunnah at home, wear a mask and go, no problem. But if you say, I will not go because you are afraid, it's totally wrong. It is not Islamic. Because the Muslim believes that whatever happens will happen with the qadr of Allah. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad said, tie your camel and trust in God. You have to tie a camel, but don't strangulate your camel when there's no need to close the mosque. COVID-19 hasn't entered your country, no one has died, and you want to close the mosque. You're not tying your camel, you are strangulating your camel. Once you strangulate the camel, then how can you ask Allah to help the camel? So, if they consult with the medical authorities, and if they say it's required, then you can do it. If the government has specifically said, we will not close down the mosque, it is fard, you should pray your 5 times salah in the mosque, and even your Jummah salah in the mosque. Hope that answers the question.